गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल डिस्कस वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक इन 16th ग्रुप एलिमेंट्स, अलोट्रोफिक फॉर्म्स ऑफ सल्फर. सल्फर एग्जिबिट्स टू टाइप्स ऑफ अलोट्रोफिक फॉर्म्स इन येलो कलर. वन इज येलो रोम्बिक सल्फर एंड येलो मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर. ओके, येलो रोम्बिक सल्फर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज अल्फा सल्फर, येलो मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज बीटा सल्फर. ओके, हियर विल डिस्कस अबाउट द rhombic sulfur. After that we'll discuss about the monoclinic sulfur. Okay, here rhombic sulfur, yellow in color, it is insoluble in water, partially soluble in ether, benzene, completely soluble in CH2, carbon disulfide. When it mixed with the carbon disulfide and here heat, we'll get the roll rhombic sulfur. And here rhombic sulfur, the boiling point of rhombic sulfur is 385.8 Kelvin. The boiling point of rhombic sulfur is 385.8. Okay, and rhombic sulfur it is stable at 369 Kelvin temperature. Alpha sulfur stable at 369 Kelvin temperature. And here it available in the form of SC8 and S6 and S2 form. S2 form is unstable form. This form available at nearly 1000 Kelvin, minus 1000 Kelvin temperature. And S2 form is the paramagnetic in nature. S2 form of sulfur is paramagnetic nature. Like a oxygen, O2 also paramagnetic in nature. Already we discussed in the first PUC. Like S2 form also paramagnetic in nature. And here it is stable at minus 1000 Kelvin temperature. Okay, this is about the importance of rhombic sulfur. And here monoclinic sulfur. How monoclinic sulfur was formed? Okay, when you are heating the alpha sulfur at 369 Kelvin temperature, forms beta sulfur. Okay, below 369 Kelvin, beta sulfur will be stable. Okay, above 369, alpha sulfur stable. But at 369 Kelvin, both will be stable. At 369 Kelvin, alpha converts into beta sulfur. Okay, completely alpha converts into beta sulfur. This temperature is called as transition temperature of alpha sulfur. 369 Kelvin temperature is simply considered as a transition temperature of alpha sulfur. And here important discussion of the monoclinic sulfur. It is also yellow in color. It is readily soluble in carbon disulfide. The melting point of this one is 393 Kelvin temperature. The melting point of monoclinic sulfur is 393 Kelvin temperature. It also readily soluble in CH2, like here rhombic sulfur. It also available in SC8 form and S6 form and S2 form at minus 1000 Kelvin temperature. S2 form here also paramagnetic nature. SC8 is available in SC8 form. SC8 form means in SC8 we have crown structure. In S6 form means here we have boat shape, and here chair shapes are available. Chair shape is stable, but not the boat. Here crown also stable. We'll discuss crown structure. We'll see the crown structure and boat structure and chair structure of this sulfur. Here SC8 available in crown shape model. S6 available in boat shape and chair shape. Always chair shape is more stable. Here we'll discuss these shapes and along with the bond angles. Here I wanted to discuss about the SC8 form and S6 form. Okay, here first I want to discuss the S8 crown shape, crown structure. Crown structure means, okay, here sulfur, okay, here sulfur, here sulfur, 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 sulfur. This is simply called as crown shape. Here we have the way to the crown. Here we are wearing the crown. Okay, this is the crown structure. 6 and 8 now. Okay, this is the simple crown structure of okay, here rhombic sulfur or monoclinic sulfur. Okay, here bond angle is 107 degrees. Here bond angle is 107 degrees. And here boat shape and chair shape S6 form. Boat means here, this is the boat shape. Here sulfur, here sulfur, here sulfur, here sulfur, here sulfur. Here it is a boat shape. And chair shape, this is the chair shape. Here bond angle is 103.2 degrees. Here sulfur, here sulfur, here sulfur, here sulfur, here sulfur, here sulfur. Okay, this is the chair form. It is stable. Okay, it is unstable. Okay, these are the structures of crown structure and okay, boat and chair structure, chair shapes of sulfur, S8 and S6 forms. This is about the allotropic forms of sulfur. This is about the okay, sulfur. Then in continuation, we'll see the discussion of dioxygen. Dioxygen. What is the meaning of dioxygen? Molecular oxygen. It is also called as molecular oxygen. Okay, it is also paramagnetic in nature. It contains even number of electrons. It contains even number of electrons. But when we are drawing the molecular orbital energy diagram according to the LCMO method, linear combination of atomic orbitals, linear combination of atomic orbitals, by that we'll draw the molecular orbital energy diagram. In that molecular orbital energy diagram, we have the lone electrons present in 2p pi orbital, 2py pi orbital, 2pz pi orbital. Due to the presence of those lone electrons, oxygen exhibits, okay, oxygen, O2 exhibits, O2 molecule exhibits the paramagnetic nature. O2 shows, okay, paramagnetic nature. That we call as dioxygen. Dioxygen. The formula of dioxygen is O2. Okay, here, dioxygen first prepared by Scheele in laboratory by using potassium chlorate. This is the one of the important gas. Okay, this is mainly involved in the respiration process. It reacts with the hemoglobin and form the oxyhemoglobin. And it is the responsible for the so many physiological activities in the human body. Okay, we'll see the preparation of this dioxygen. When you are heating potassium chlorate or potassium nitrate, potassium chlorate or any, okay, potassium permanganate also, okay, will give dioxygen. When you are heating this one in the presence of manganese dioxide, at least here, what happen? Here we get the potassium chloride and here nascent oxygen along with the oxygen. Or this may be written like this. Take 2 moles of this one. Potassium chlorate will get the potassium chloride. And 3 moles of oxygen will be, dioxygen will be liberated and dioxygen will be formed in the presence of manganese, okay, dioxide, manganese dioxide. Okay, then thermal decomposition of any oxide, mercuric oxide, thermal decomposition of mercuric oxide. Okay, here lead monoxide. Okay, lead dioxide. Okay, lead dioxide and lead oxide, Pb3O4. Okay, here Pb3O4 and here lead dioxide, magnesium oxide, calcium oxide. Okay, or any oxide, silver oxide, Ag2O. Okay, the thermal decomposition of this one, all heat here, heat of all oxides. Okay, here will give only dioxygen. Okay, here will give dioxygen along with the concerned product, along with the concerned mercury. Here lead form, here lead form, here also lead form, here magnesium form, here calcium form, here okay silver form, along with the metal. Dioxygen will be formed, along with dioxygen we will get the metal. Here we will get the metal. This is the second method. And the thermal decomposition of peroxide, sodium peroxide, potassium peroxide, sodium peroxide, potassium peroxide, or any peroxide, hydrogen peroxide also. The thermal decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, sodium peroxide, what happen? Readily give the hydrogen and oxygen. Here also 2 moles of sodium and releases oxygen gas, dioxygen gas. Dioxygen gas, readily give the dioxygen gas. And here some more important methods are there. Electrolysis of water. Okay, electrolysis of water. By electrolysis of water also we'll get the oxygen at anode. Take 2 moles of water, pass electricity through anode and cathode. Already we know about the complete description of this one. Okay, here we'll get the, okay, here hydrogen gas was liberated at cathode. And here oxygen gas was liberated at anode. This is the fundamental equation of electrolysis of water. Okay, for bulk process, for bulk, if we need bulk amount of oxygen, we'll use this method, electrolysis of water. By the electrolysis of water, we'll prepare the, okay, here we'll prepare the oxygen gas. Oxygen is liberated at anode. And here, one more. Fractional distillation. Okay, fractional distillation of air. Air contains 72% of nitrogen, 22%, 22% of oxygen. Okay, these both are having different boiling points. Okay, nitrogen and oxygen both are having different boiling points. Okay, if we do the fractional distillation of this air, okay, here air and oxygen and nitrogen separated. This method was used for the preparation of nitrogen as well as oxygen. Okay, a nitrogen and as well as oxygen gas. Okay, this is the fractional distillation of air also will prepare the oxygen. Okay, electrolysis of water also will prepare the oxygen. The thermal decomposition of metal oxides, thermal decomposition of peroxide also will prepare the oxygen. The heating of chlorates, permanganates, sulfates, nitrates, or any, okay, metal oxygen containing molecules will get the here oxygen. This is the first method. Okay, laboratory method for the preparation of the oxygen. It is used by the Scheele. This is the important method. Okay, first laboratory oxygen prepared method. Okay, here oxygen prepared in the laboratory by using this method only. These are the, okay, methods for the preparation of the dioxygen. In continuation, we'll see the properties of dioxygen. Properties, chemical properties or physical properties, and along with the structure. Oxygen is paramagnetic substance. Already I explained it contains even number of electrons. Dioxygen, okay, 8 plus 8, 16 electrons, but it is a, okay, paramagnetic substance. Okay, it has, Okay, in this molecule, when we draw the molecular orbital energy diagram of oxygen molecule, okay, 2PY orbital, 2PZ orbital contains, okay, one lone electron, that's why it exhibits the paramagnetic nature. It exhibits paramagnetic nature and oxygen forms double bond with the another oxygen. In that way, oxygen forms one single bond and one sigma bond and one pi bond with the another oxygen. Oxygen diatom always oxygen available in all diatomic form, O2 form. Okay, then in continuation we'll see the properties of dioxygen. Okay, dioxygen is colorless gas, odorless gas. Okay, here it is. Maximum extent soluble in water. Here 3.08 cubic centimeter. Amount of oxygen soluble in 100 cubic centimeter water. 100 cubic centimeter water at 298 Kelvin temperature. This much amount of gas was dissolved. At 100 cubic centimeter water at nearly 298 Kelvin temperature. And here, it exhibit. Already we know about the oxygen. We know about the isotopic forms of oxygen. It shows three isotopic forms: oxygen 16, oxygen 17, oxygen 18. But oxygen 16 is 99% available. That's why it is a more stable. Oxygen 16 is the more stable. Isotopic form. More stable isotopic form of oxygen. And here, it is an important gas. It involves in respiration. It reacts with hemoglobin and form the oxyhemoglobin. This oxyhemoglobin involves in so many physiological activities which are present in human body. Physiological activities. And here dioxygen reacts with any metal. It may be metal or non-metal. It reacts with sodium, it reacts with calcium, it reacts with boron, it reacts with carbon, it reacts with nitrogen, it reacts with phosphorus, it reacts with sulfur, it reacts with chlorine. Here it reacts with chlorine and form the concerned oxides. Sodium reacts with oxygen and form Na2O oxide, sodium oxide, sodium peroxide, sodium superoxide. Calcium reacts with oxygen and form calcium monoxide, calcium normal oxide, calcium peroxide. Boron reacts with oxygen and forms boron trioxide. Carbon reacts with oxygen and forms carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, neutral oxide, carbon dioxide, acidic oxide. Nitrogen reacts with oxygen, forms nitrous oxide, nitric oxide. Nitrogen dioxide, nitrogen trioxide, nitrogen tetroxide, nitrogen pentoxide. Phosphorus also reacts with oxygen and form P4O6 phosphorus trioxide. It is simply called as P2O3, P4O8, P4O10, P2O5 pentoxide. Sulfur also reacts with oxygen and forms sulfur dioxide, sulfur monoxide, sulfur trioxide, sulfur tetroxide, sulfur heptoxide. Sulfur pentoxide also is there, but sulfur trioxide and sulfur dioxide are the more stable oxide. Chlorine also reacts with oxygen and forms chlorine monoxide, chlorine dioxide, chlorine trioxide, chlorine pentoxide and chlorine heptoxide. These are the different oxides. Metals, that means copper also reacts with oxygen and forms cuprous oxide. Cuprous oxide and cupric oxide. Silver also reacts with oxygen and forms silver oxide. except noble gaseous. Okay, except noble gaseous means xenon also reacts with oxygen and forms xenon trioxide and xenon tetroxide. Okay, different remaining noble gases, krypton, okay, argon, not reacts with the oxygen, and noble metals like gold and platinum not reacts with the oxygen. Except these, okay, except some of the noble gases, okay, except xenon, some of the noble gases and okay, noble metals like gold and platinum not reacts with the oxygen or not form the oxide. But all the elements which are present in a periodic table reacts with oxygen and form the concerned oxides. In presence of oxygen, okay, some of the molecules involved in oxidation process. Okay, suppose for example, sulfur dioxide converts into sulfur trioxide. Sulfur dioxide oxidized into sulfur trioxide. Hydrochloric acid oxidized into chlorine. Hydrochloric acid oxidized into chlorine. Here we discuss those oxidation reaction. Okay, oxidizing property of oxygen. We'll discuss oxidizing property of that oxygen. Okay, here. Sulfur dioxide in conduct process will prepare sulfuric acid by using this method. Sulfur dioxide reacts with oxygen. 2 moles of sulfur dioxide reacts with oxygen. In presence of vanadium pentoxide forms 2 moles of sulfur trioxide. Here sulfur dioxide oxidized into sulfur trioxide. Here oxidation number plus 4. Here oxidation number plus 6. Plus 4 to plus 6 increases. So, okay, this is called as oxidizing property of oxygen. And here hydrochloric acid, okay, here I am taking 4 moles of hydrochloric acid, reacts with oxygen in presence of cuprous chloride. In presence of cuprous chloride, what happen here, we'll get 2 moles of water along with the 2 moles of chlorine gas was evolved. Okay, here oxidation number of chlorine is minus 1, oxidation number of chlorine is 0, minus 1 to 0 increased, so it is also one of the important oxidation reaction. Here hydrochloric acid oxidized into chlorine and here sulfur dioxide oxidized into sulfur trioxide. These are the important oxidizing properties of oxygen. Oxidizing properties of oxygen. Okay, here uses of oxygen. So many uses are there. Okay, oxygen mainly used in respiration process and combustion process. So many materials involves in catch the fire or involves in combustion in the presence of only oxygen. So many metabolic activities or physiological activities which are present in human body, those also carried out in the presence of oxygen only. Liquid oxygen used in hospital. Okay, used in the hospital for the artificial respiration. Nowadays, okay, if coronavirus attacks on human body, what happened? The reactivity of oxygen toward the hemoglobin decreases. Okay, that we measured by using oximeter. Okay, for the improving the reactivity of oxygen and the reactivity of oxygen, we are using artificial oxygen cylinders by giving the different chemical substances. Okay, that is also one of the important phenomenon of oxygen nowadays. Okay, it is also decreases, reactivity of oxygen also decreases by the attacking of coronavirus. Okay, here liquid oxygen also used in the manufacture of so many metals and so welding process. It also used in the welding process. Okay, that we called as oxyacetylene torch, different torches are available. Okay, in the welding process, the welding means to connecting the two metals. Okay, for the connecting of two metals, we are heating two metals at high temperature by passing the acetylene or by passing the any metal in the presence of oxygen. Okay, that we called as oxyacetylene torch. Oxyacetylene torch also can be done in the presence of oxygen only. These are the uses of dioxygen. Okay, then in continuation, we'll see the structure of dioxygen. Okay, already we know about the structure of dioxygen. Okay, here oxygen, And here, how many lone electrons are present in oxygen? Six electrons are present. Okay, here, okay, shows this is the pi bond, this is the sigma bond. Okay, here oxygen, and here one oxygen. Okay, here oxygen. Oxygen, this is the sigma bond, and here this is the pi bond. This is the pi bond. It has only two lone electrons, that's why it forms one sigma bond and one pi bond. One sigma bond and one pi bond. Okay, it contains even number of electrons. Even number of electrons, but it shows paramagnetic nature. Paramagnetic nature. Okay, here bond order of oxygen. Bond order of oxygen is 2. Bond order of oxygen is. So this is about the structure of dioxygen and here oxidizing properties and uses of dioxygen. Okay, uses of dioxygen. Okay, in continuation we'll discuss ozone. Ozone means O3. Okay, O3. Okay, we'll discuss preparation properties and structure of ozone, resonance structures of ozone. Okay, in continuation. Thank you.